Welcome to Teams on Air, brought to you by Microsoft. Thanks for joining us on demand. Our episodes are also streamed live every other Thursday at 9 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. During the live show, we give you the opportunity to participate in our Q&A. So if you ever have any questions about our upcoming topics, be sure to join live and our subject matter experts will be responding in the background. You can also listen to us on the go through podcasts, iTunes, Google Play, and everywhere podcasts can be found. If there are any specific topics you'd like us to cover, leave us a comment on our latest YouTube video. And remember to subscribe to our playlist to get the latest updates. If you ever like our episode, make sure you give us a big thumbs up. All right, let's get to the show. Thank you for joining another episode of Teams on Air. Today we're going to be talking about Microsoft Teams and a day in a life in only a mobile phone. And as you can see, we have no PCs. We're going to be doing this exclusively on our mobile devices. In order to help me do that, I brought Swati. Swati, thanks for joining us today.
Thank you for having me here, Delanda.
Now, Swati, before we jump into our demo and all the mobile capabilities, I'd love for you to tell us how long you've been here at Microsoft and what you're doing on the Teams team.
Sure, I would love to share. Hi, everyone. I'm Swati Jhawar, a product manager with Microsoft for 9 years now and with Microsoft Teams since day one. I love how Microsoft Teams has made me more productive and how connected I feel with my team today.
That's fantastic. So I know you work on Teams every day, so I'm not going to bother to ask you. But what I'd really love to do is get into what you do as the first thing when you wake up in the morning.
Sure. I would love to share with you how I spend my entire day using just Microsoft Teams mobile client. So first thing with my morning coffee is I start with my activity tab. It helps me quickly catch up on anybody who has followed up on my responses, or I have mentioned me, liked me, or have tried getting my attention, or even if I have some missed calls or voicemail notifications. From there, I switch to chat, where, as you can see, all the unread ones are easily highlighted and I can quickly go and catch up on them or just jump into them and respond from there. Then I move to Teams. I can quickly switch between various teams that I'm a member of. I can pick a particular channel in a team and start deep diving. As you can see, people are participating from different parts of the continent. They are sharing their content. They are talking about any feedback, brainstorming, anything that they want to do as a close-knit team working on a common project together. And they can choose the language of their preference to just do the communication. So I can, from here, I can go and mark something as unread if I have to follow up with more details or I want to think through before I get involved into that discussion. I can just click on save, and this helps me keep this information saved so that I can just browse over those things anytime that I want later in the day.
Nice.
I can jump on starting a new thread where I have capabilities to compose in rich text editor. But in Microsoft Teams, we believe like a picture speaks for 1,000 words. A Giphy speaks for 10,000 words because I can express my emotions, my thoughts, all through that single Giphy.
Yeah.
So I can just quickly jump onto it, search for what I'm looking for or how I'm starting my day and quickly send it to my team. The best part here is I can actually just bring up an attachment anytime by browsing it on my files which are uploaded anywhere in the cloud. And I can also just jump to Files tab to quickly start browsing various files that are shared in this particular channel. Like you can see, I can have access on all the files that anybody has shared in this particular channel for the entire team working together, sharing their notes and collaborating.
All right, this is fantastic. So all the features and capabilities that I see on my desktop or web client, I can see them in my phone.
Oh yeah, absolutely. The fundamental philosophy with which we work in Microsoft Teams, we believe today organizations have evolved significantly, both in their work styles and workforces. Today, work is more social, global, and no more just limited to one device, which we used to call as office computer.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we have built Microsoft Teams on mobile client to untether collaboration, to empower our fast-paced users to be more productive on the go.
Nice. Now, I know you've walked us through what you do when you wake up in the morning with your coffee. Now, I know a big portion of your day is spent in meetings. How can we use the mobile phone to join meetings?
Sure, meetings are an important part of my life. Whether I'm in office or outside, my mobile client absolutely helps me to make sure I get into my meetings. We have Meetings tab in the app, which helps you get a quick snapshot of how your day looks like. I can quickly scan and look into all the meetings that I have today, tomorrow, and for next couple of days. I can join a meeting, and while I'm in the meeting, and if I have to talk to somebody else, I can just mute myself, or I can go and place my call on hold. And once my discussion is done, I can resume the call on the go. Along with that, I can now share content into meeting. By which I mean I can now pick a photo which could be from the recent gallery that is available, or I can just switch to my phone gallery and bring any picture and start presenting into the meeting. This is the picture we took, by the way, celebrating Microsoft Teams 1 year anniversary last month. Nice. And this is my awesome Microsoft Teams mobile client team.
Awesome. So now you can take pictures from your phone and project them into meetings and everyone
Absolutely.
Can see them. That's really fantastic.
Yeah. Along with pictures, many times it happens that you are on site somewhere and you want to share in meeting what you are seeing there, or you want to get some feedback from the members in the team. I can just go, start a video, make sure this is what I want to present by confirming, and then I start presenting into the meeting. Hey, Delanda. Now
hey.
Everyone in the meeting can see you.
Hey, everyone.
Yay. So not only sharing, but now I can consume content while in the meeting using my mobile client. Mm-hmm. For example, if somebody is sharing a PowerPoint presentation into a meeting happening in a room, or I'm participating remotely into that meeting, I can view that PowerPoint presentation both in portrait mode and in the landscape mode as well. When I can see the content into my meeting using mobile client, I can actually view the PowerPoint presentation into the private mode without affecting anybody else into the meeting. And anytime when I want, I can get back to where the presenter of the meeting is by just pressing on back to the presenter.
Right.
I can also request to take control to remotely start controlling the PowerPoint presentation and then just driving slides right from there. And everybody in the meeting can just be with me while I'm talking, sharing content, and as well as presenting.
So that you don't have to do anymore, can you please go to the next slide? You can control it for yourself.
Oh, gone are those days where I have to request somebody in the meeting, hey, can you go to the next slide? No more. I can just use my mobile as my remote control.
Nice.
Yeah. So now, along with sharing, consuming content, there are a lot of other cool things that we are doing. You can now share your screen using your iPad or an iPhone, and can share with anybody in the meeting any file, any app, any document that you want to present into the meeting. Along with that, we have also enabled capabilities like Call Me Back. So if I am taking meeting with nice, awesome Wi-Fi connection and I'm stepping out driving, I can just request server to call me back in, and then they can get me into the meeting.
Nice.
Yeah, and another cool thing that we have done is not only my outgoing video, but because I'm traveling and I'm on data, I can also just turn off my incoming video to improve my call quality or save my data bandwidth.
Now, I noticed that the video for the attendees also changed too. Did their video get turned off with the setting?
Yeah, because it's not just I'm controlling my outgoing, but I can control all the incoming video also and can decide how I want to optimize my experience on the go.
All right, perfect.
Yeah.
Now, those are a lot of rich capabilities that you can do with your phone, and you don't really need your PC, but what about just a traditional old phone call? Can we make a phone call with the Teams app?
I'm glad you asked, because that's one of my favorite features on mobile client. I can just switch to the calls app. I can catch up on my call history, as you can see here. I can quickly just tap and place a call to a PSTN number or to a person in my tenant. I can start a quick audio call, video call over VoIP. I can do a chat, a quick chat from here with anyone in the organization, or just jump to view their profile card. I can switch to voicemail tab, where not only I can hear a voicemail, but I can read the transcript as well on the speed that I am interested in. All the PSTN capable users can also switch to a dial pad which is right there. And then you can place a national call or an international call and just get going on the go.
That's great. Now, does this sync with my phone? So does it look at the contacts on my phone as well? And can I call those?
Such a great question. Right from here, you can just tap onto the device contacts and it can pull any contact from your device and enables you to place a call to them.
Perfect.
Yeah, you can now even in meetings invite participants not only by their names, but actually by their numbers, and you can get them added into the meetings.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah.
Wow, so you could have a pretty productive day with just your mobile phone and the Teams app installed on that. So these are really great basic calling capabilities. Can we do something more advanced for the scenarios where I'm on vacation or I might have an admin who and I need some of her support?
That's a great question and thanks for asking that. Along with the basic calling capabilities, we also make sure that you never have to leave any call unanswered by offering some advanced calling capabilities. You can just go into the settings under Callings tab and we offer you to set your call forward to a PSTN number or any person in your organization. You can also set a simultaneous ring where if I'm not there to answer, it can at the same time ring you as well. So I can just enable like call forwarding, go to forward to and set it to a voicemail or a contact or a number. Along with call forwarding and simultaneous ring, we are also enabling capabilities like call delegation or you can transfer call as a safe transfer or by consulting someone and then transferring the call to them.
Nice. So we have the VoIP calling capabilities, we have meeting capabilities, and we also have the advanced phone system capabilities and configuration settings right directly in the phone.
Yes, you have all the power right in your mobile client to get everything done. But another thing that I want to highlight is that through settings, you can now control what type of notifications you would be interested in.
Yeah.
Do you want to get only notified when someone is trying to get your attention by mentioning you or direct one-on-one chats with you? Versus you want to follow a particular channel with any post that anybody is doing there. So you can optimize for a lot of those notifications right from here and feel that you have the power to customize it the way you want.
That's fantastic. So when I wake up in the morning, I can go directly to a channel and triage my day in channels, but I can also triage how I get notified of things that are happening. So that is awesome. So thank you for walking us a day in the life of using the mobile phone. I have tons of questions, but before we do that, let's take a quick break and look at some of the apps in Teams.
Hi, I'm Ann Michaels. Welcome to Teams Tips. In this segment, I will give you some quick and easy tips how you can better use Microsoft Teams. So when you have a chat conversation in Teams, it often happens that you just start that conversation with one or two people, but you get to a point where you need to add somebody else. And you don't want to copy all of the content and start from scratch. So to help you with that, you can now go ahead and share a chat in Teams easily. All you have to do is click on the little plus icon at the right corner here at the top, and then you have three options. You can either start from scratch and not share any chat history, but you can then keep the same people in that conversation, or you can choose to share all chat history. The third option is that you can be very specific and decide exactly how many days of chat history you want to share. And then simply type the name. In our example here, I will add Carl to our conversation, and that's it. For more Teams tips, follow us on Twitter, hashtag Teams Tips.
All right, welcome back. Swati, I have tons of questions, and I want to start off with our intelligent communications vision. We've been talking about that for several months now. Tell me how we're bringing intelligence into the mobile app.
Sure, I would love to share that. So in mobile, we are looking from a lot of angles how to optimize the experience of the user on the go. So for instance, some of the experiences that I would love to share with you. If you are on the call and into a full connected Wi-Fi, and then you step into your car while your call is still going on, we make sure that we automatically switch you from Wi-Fi to the LTE or 4G connection that you have without dropping the call, so that the call quality and user experience remains consistent. We have also enabled some of the capabilities like by telling user that if you are in a poor network connection and you are on a video call, how you can get into the meeting by PSTN quick one-click dial-in into the meeting. Mm-hmm. or that you can just turn off your video so that you can have a better call quality in your poor network connection scenario. Like, we have also optimized experience where as soon as we detect that you have low battery, we suggest that in order for you to have a better call experience, probably switch from video to audio mode.
Yeah.
So a lot of those mobile specific, mobile first experience is what we are targeting.
That's great. Yeah. So the app is doing a lot of the thinking on mm-hmm. our behalf, right? So we don't have to worry about, you know, how long this call is going to last. Is my battery is going to die?
It's
thinking about that on my behalf.
Yeah.
All right, cool. Another question that I have is about the future. Like, what's happening next with the mobile phone? So talk to me about some of the capabilities that we're bringing to life.
Thanks for asking that. That's what makes me feel more excited working with Microsoft Teams, that everything that I showed you today is what we have now. And then we constantly keep thinking about what's next. So some of those which I shared with you today, how we are doing network optimization or battery, and we are also working on bandwidth optimization to offer a better user experience, no matter you are on whatever bandwidth while traveling. Along with that, I shared with you how we can share now media content into the meeting, and soon you'll be able to share files with different formats into the meeting.
Mm-hmm.
From there, we are also focused on a very cool thing that we are working, which is proximity detection. So your device will be so smart that it will be able to find the rooms around you. So say you jump on a call, it can quickly find which are the rooms with devices capable of joining the meeting are available, and you quickly go get that device added, get that room into your meeting, and get going from there.
Nice.
So based on proximity, we'll be able to find if you are invited in that meeting or if that device is available and can get in your meeting.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Now, I know we demoed some of those capabilities on stage at Enterprise Connect. What about the voice capabilities and voice commands? How is that going to light up on our mobile experience?
Sure. So as you must have seen in Enterprise Connect, some of the cool demos that we did of Cortana integration and Teams. So definitely that's the path in which we are focusing right now. It's very difficult today if I have to do a two people call by searching everybody's name, type, and then picking a suggestion and then starting my call. How cool the world would be when I can just press a button and say, hey, call this and this person in my organization, and it just gets me into the call. In the call, I can say, I can quickly find out when is my next meeting, when am I available. We can just plan the meeting, get it onto the schedule, and keep going. So a lot of cool things, which I'm very excited about, which will be lighting up in Microsoft Teams soon.
All right, Swati, this was so exciting. Thank you so much for spending time with us today and showing us the day in the life of Microsoft Teams on the mobile client. This has been really exciting. For those of you out in our audience, make sure that you go to either Apple or Android Store and download the Teams mobile app. Anything else you want to say before we leave?
Yeah, absolutely. We would love to get your ratings, your feedback on both these stores. We read every feedback and take it seriously, and would love to incorporate all of that to make you more and more productive on the go.
All right, well, that's that for this week's episode. We'll see you in 2 weeks.